How much for a hairy crown?
Need to chat.
I'm all ears, Witcher.
Vladimir sends his love.
You spoke to him. Impossible.
Did more than that. Fulfilled your wish. And talked to him extensively. Curious what he had to say? Fulfilled your wish. Your dead brother had himself one more day like those of old.
Very easy to say. But have you got any proof?
I do.
Vladimir's hand. It's unmistakable. You've done well, Witcher. Need something else?
Third wish. Time you stated it.
A moment, Geralt. I must say to something. Then we'll chat. You there. Yank the herring out the barrel.
Come on! None of this dallying!
Now, ready to listen? Or do you still not give two shits about what I've got to say?
I'm ready! I'm listening!
Good. You'll return to your lord and tell him as follows. His demand was brazen. Hurt me to the core. For I was brought up to respect the sacred law of hospitality. And I shall not bend to an uncouth boor's dictum. Understood? I will pay him a visit shortly to test his willingness to adapt. So you ride off and announce me. And don't spare your horse. Got it?
Aye, got it.
Give this man a mount and leave him go. Come, Witcher. We must talk outside. The Aethiri believe one should only discuss important matters out of doors, with the gods as witnesses.
Beryl, what was that about?
On the way here, we stopped for nourishment at a tavern belonging to one Lord Dauntless. We enjoyed ourselves as one does at an inn. Raucously. Our antics were not to the liking of this Dauntless. Sent a man to warn us that if we were ever to return, we would hang.
You burned the inn down?
I left ample compensation with the innkeep. But it seems the rapscallion neglected to mention this to his lord. But that's of little import. What matters is someone called me a whoreson and threatened to kill me. It was one of those threats that sound like an invitation. I intend to accept it. Return to those parts.
Must have made quite a few enemies along the way. Maybe not today and not tomorrow, but someday someone will find a way to take you down.
And that should trouble me why. I feel no fear, no regret. The wise men of Oxenfurt claim there are no gods. After death, there is only the void. I've known this void already. Death holds no surprises.
fulfilled two of your wishes. Time I learned the third.
Confident, aren't you? Proud, sure of your strengths. Fearless.
Third task, if you don't mind.
Mutations. They stripped you of emotion. Tell me, have you ever loved? I mean, truly loved.
Yeah, I've loved. Can we get to the matter at hand?
Perhaps instead we ought to sit down inside. Have a good chat over some fiery water.
We'll drink once the job's done.
Afraid that's impossible. Succeed and that's the end of me. Fail and you'll not be back.
Third wish, still waiting to hear it.
Aye, aren't you stubborn? Fine. Listen well. I had a wife once. The day I saw her last, I gave her a rose. A violet one. Bring me that blue. Wouldn't mind reminding myself what it looks like.
When was that? How long's it been? Flowers wilted and turned to dust by now.
You wished to hear a wish. Now you have. Fulfill it. I ride now to visit this Dauntless, but one of my men will remain here. He'll know how to find me. That is, of course, should you succeed.
At least you could tell me where your wife is.
In my old manor, east of Martin Foy's farmstead. I'd wish you godspeed, but, well, you understand, I'm sure. Goodbye, Geralt.
Emperor can kiss my ass.
Arms
they found another corpse yesterday. Drained to the last drop, not an ounce.
Finally met his match. Some cutthroat of Witcher, I think, gave Junior his due.
So, nothing to cheer about with us.
Witcher, as I live and breathe.
Bite marks, armor ripped to shreds. No sign of another corpse. flying monster. Gripped the second body in its claws. Didn't quite get everything to its nest. Piece by piece, follow the thread. Tracks end here. Damn birds must have picked the ground clean, but they've already found the rest of the corpse, probably. All I gotta do is follow the cawing. Empty, except for leftovers. Well, well. They took on this contract before I did. Got the reward up front. More than they're paying me. Thin rakides. Sparse after feathers. Interesting. An archgriffin.
Oh, you're fucked.
Don't let him catch it!
That's it, Roach.
cheaters too. Purse I got was full of counterfeit crowns. Look at here. Bronze with just a lick of gold on it.
The Redanian coffers are near empty. Time to cross the portal.
See if there's any work for us.
Well,
there.
Any progress?
Run, Roach.
Hear about the contract.
Whew, a taker at long last. Poverty in everyone's lips, but when you've a job to give, no one's eager. Folk are lazy, that's the truth of it.
Stick to the point if you don't mind.
Right. Sorry for the chatter. I'm anxious, is all. Been so long without any word. It's my apprentice, Falkert. I sent him to the Dead White Wood. You know, the forest near Martin Foy's farmstead. I'd run out of hand fiber, see, and the damned stuff grows thick as weeds there.
Let me guess. Hasn't returned.
Yes. No, he hasn't. Please, find him and bring him back safe and sound.
No promises, but I can certainly look for him. Any distinguishing features? How will I recognize him?
Got to think on that. Well, he's a halfling, as I am. Light hair. Will that do?
It'll have to. So long.
Come on, Roach. That's it, Roach.
Faster.
Good grief.
Herbalist's cart. Got some blood here. Blood. Dried. A few days old. Trail's gone cold. Need to look around. Ask. Maybe someone's seen him.
Thank you.
The curse that held Uma proved hard to lift, but Yennefer and the Witchers managed to do it. The ugliest man alive revealed himself to be not man, but elf, and an elven sage at that. Avalach, for this was his name, was the elven mage who had helped Ciri flee the hunt, then hidden her away on the Isle of Mists.
Blood. Dried. A few days old. Trail's gone cold. Need to look around. Ask. Maybe someone's seen him. Stains, months old.
Sharp now! We've company. What's brought you to these parts, Master? Lost your way?
No. Looking for someone.
Ah. Do tell. Perhaps we can help.
What is this place, exactly?
A village. Plain to see.
Abandoned huts is about all I see.
Aye. It's only us now. Young folk are gone off to the city seeking work, and the old have all died. Ain't that right, Judd?
Right as rain.
Bloodstains in the hut next door. Know anything about that?
Aye, of course. Judd Gut's game in there.
In someone else's hut?
None live there no more, see? And working neath the roof, it's more pleasant, civilized. Rain don't whip and sun don't blind.
But why poke your nose in there to start with?
Do better to give an old couple some peace.
Looking for someone named Fulkert. Light-haired halfling. Ring any bells?
Saw a little one round here, out picking herbs.
Mm-hmm. till he got hurt. Ran across a trail of blood. Trail led me here.
It is just as you say. Wolves had attacked him. He fled here seeking shelter. I told him, back to your city, young master. Plenty such dangers hereabouts. But the fool was stubborn. Said he had to pick his blooms aforehand. Ventured back into the woods. And that were the last of him. Heard howling that night. Sent shivers down my spine.
So where are his remains? Wolves would have left something. His boots, maybe.
Didn't go looking. But he's too old to go tramping about in the woods.
So long. Rotting meat. Halfling. Must be Fulkert. Ripped open, gutted and drained. No way to determine the cause of death. To your larder. Meat-rich diet. That what you like?
Master, not at all. Tain't like that.
Best hope not, or you'll be next to get a hook through your neck.
The wolves killed him. Him and the others. We but gather the bodies. That's the truth.
We're old and frail. We've no strength to plow or sow, but we gotta eat. Have pity, Master.
folks say we witchers have no feelings, it's a barefaced lie. Right now, I feel rage, and I can't wait to vent.
Chop you up! We'll stick you in a stew!
Faster. Slow now. Whoa.
Let's go!
looks like rain.